बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ माय लेक्चर नंबर 9। आई एम प्रोफेसर आसिफ शौकत, योर केमिस्ट्री टीचर। टुडे वी हैव टू कवर मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ इथाइन। इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर, लेक्चर नंबर 8 एंड लेक्चर नंबर 7, वी हैव लर्न्ड more about methods of preparation of ethene and methane as well. I'm just making you able to identify how chemical reaction starts. Also, I have given you a hint that in every organic chemical reaction we have to only identify breakage of old bonds and formation of new bonds. In this case, while learning methods of preparation of ethyne, few things are quite similar to the previous knowledge. The first method is by dehydrohalogenation of 1,1,2,2 tetrabromoethane. Students, I have taken bromo here just to make a good sense about halogens. You may replace this bromine either with chlorine or iodine, but it would be more beautiful at this stage. Instead of having chlorine, you just replace it with bromine, so that a different variety of learning can be achieved. Let's start. Look into the heading. I taught you that heading can help you out about the whole reaction. What we have to do? We have to understand first what is D. D mean you have to remove. What you have to remove? Halogen. Which one is the halogen here? Bromo. You have to remove bromo from 1,1,2,2 tetrabromoethane. What is 1,1,2,2 tetrabromoethane? This is C2H2 and Br4. You have to make equation first smartly. Like ethyne would be produced if you will use this compound. What is this? It is 1,1,2,2 tetrabromoethane. When I will make the structure, this IOPAC name would also be clear. You have to think about the condition, that which is the suitable condition for the removal of halogen only. In my last lecture, in preparation of ethene, we did the same reaction. For the removal of halogen, we used zinc dust. So keep it in your mind, these necessary conditions are very much important, and you have to remember continuously that only zinc dust is capable to remove bromine from this compound, and you will observe the complete formation of ethyne. If this combination is added, then you have to make this equation balance as well. Place 4 with it or 2 with it, whatever you want. Both can be added while depending upon the balance in the equation. In this equation, it is very much clear that C2 and H2 is obtained. After the removal of bromine, the second product would be zinc bromide, zinc bromide. For the balancing factor, if you use 2 in this stage, then there should also be 2. Now this equation is balanced. Focus on the mechanism of this reaction. I am going to draw display or the bonding structure of 1,1,2,2 dibromo sorry 1,1,2,2 tetrabromo. It's not hydrogen, it would also be bromine. There is bromine, hydrogen and hydrogen. What happens as you use zinc dust? Zinc dust is capable to remove all the bromines from this compound. There are 4 electron pairs. One bromine will leave by taking electron pair opposite to this, and other will leave by leaving its electron opposite to this. If this carbon is breaking bond by leaving all the pair of electron, one pair of electron, and opposite to this, this carbon will not leave this pair. It has to take this pair of electron, and opposite to this, this bromine will leave by taking its electron pair. Just see, this pair of electron is free, this pair is free. It will make double bond, it will make triple bond. That's how ethyne is produced and triple covalent bond exists. Students, see how beautiful is the chemistry. These bromine adds up with zinc and they makes zinc bromide. What a beautiful reaction. I love this. Now come to the second one. The second method is by dehydrohalogenation. What do you mean by D? I'm not going to write it again. You know very well, D means remove. Which one has to be removed? Hydro mean hydrogen. Halogen mean halogen. From which substance? The substance is vicinal dihalide. Students, I taught you in the previous lecture, vicinal is a trivial name of such alkyl halides in which two halogens are attached with two adjacent carbon atoms. Such dihalide is termed as vicinal. So which one is vicinal dihalide in this case? 1,2-dibromoethane. 1,2-dibromoethane is actually C2H4 and Br2. Think about the condition. Which substance is capable to remove hydrogen and halogen both? Yesterday I taught you, that is KOH, but condition would be alcoholic. If two bromine are removed, then two hydrogen would also be removed. If two hydrogen are removed, then it will leave along with two carbons only two hydrogens. So the substance is C2H2, which is our desired product. Along with it, you will get two molecules of HBr. Hydrogen and halogen both are being removed. Now please see the mechanism. It is display structure. There are two bromine and two hydrogen which are required to be eliminated or taken out from the molecule. Just see, these are the electron pairs. If one bromine leave by taking electron, other will leave by leaving electron. Opposite to this, this hydrogen cannot take pair of electron. Why? Because imbalancing creates. To balance it, it has to leave by leaving electron pair. Opposite to this, it has to leave by taking electron. It's very simple. You just have to make equilibrium or the balancing within the molecule. This electron pair is free, this one is free, it will comes here, it will comes here, it will make double bond, it will make triple bond. That's how triple bond is being made. It is just similar to the above one. The student's chemistry is very, very easy, but basic concepts need to be cleared first. If you are not clear about the basic concepts, then you cannot cope up to the level of understanding. If you already have ambiguity in your own sense, then further concepts may create some sort of difficulty in the case of understanding. Okay, now the third method is from calcium carbide. Students, calcium carbide is actually Ca and C2. Calcium carbide can produce ethane gas C2H2 when we add water. After the addition of water, you will get ethane gas along with calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide is commonly known as lime water. Let me mention the name. Lime water. What is the mechanism? These are the two carbon. There is a triple covalent bond. This one is calcium. Calcium belongs to group 2. It can make two bonds with both of the carbons. Just for my convenience, I have written water in the form of this. There are two molecules participating. That's why I can write one to the right side and other to the left side. Just see the beauty of chemistry, that this OH joins calcium, this will join calcium, this hydrogen will join carbon, this hydrogen will join carbon, and all such bonds are broken. This line is telling you about the all bonds are being broken. So focus on it. Carbon triple bond, hydrogen join it, hydrogen joins it, and calcium joins both of the hydroxyl group. That's why I am writing it here CaOH2. Students, there are these three methods for the preparation of ethane in our syllabus. Thank you very much. You have to revise all the concepts. You have to share. You have to discuss with your friends that Sir Asif is taking online classes. Please share it maximum on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, whatever is your favorite social media, medium of social media. Thank you very much.